Hi everyone, my name is Arijana Lukic and this is my first video on YouTube that I am making for you guys. I am an artist and this year I made important decisions in my life where I chose to dedicate more time into producing art, getting more creative, exploring mediums, and YouTube is one of the platforms that I find very important for the community. I think I can get a feedback from people, inspire people, get inspired by other people as well, maybe collaborate, and I mean, opportunities are just endless on that end. There are a few digital mandalas that I created. I think I have 40 of them so far. They are all on my website, arijanalukic.com. It was a fun project. I travel quite a lot, so it's nice to do something on the go. So I use an iPad for that. I print them usually 16 by 16 and they're really nice to frame. Here there's another piece of art that I made with Pebeo paints. This was just like a quick project that just popped in my mind, and I knew this medium from before because I used it in the past to make something, and the effects are just pretty amazing. I'm also making sometimes watercolor, so this is just one of the things I have created lately. I think there's maybe another one that's kind of cool. It's this one here. These are just like little projects I do. Sometimes I also carry that with myself when I'm traveling because I can actually carry a pad that fits in my purse and I can paint almost anywhere. My real babies are the Hebrew art, which I just started learning, so this is going to be a process for learning, but I'll show you one of the results that I have created lately. So this is one of them. It's actually a rice paper. This is a testing paper. It's a good paper for this, but I don't like the patterns in it, so this is just for testing. I bought one paper that doesn't have all these little treads in there to make the official trials. So this is Hebrew, and basically it's like painting marbling on water, and then you just put a paper on it and then you get your design on the paper or a fabric. It is not exactly water. I mean, you put seaweed inside, so one day I will actually go through a video for Hebrew for sure to show you guys what I'm doing. So my babies are the fluid arts, and that's one of them that I would like to perfect eventually. They say it takes 3 years to get really good at it, so that's kind of crazy, but I understand why. It's a lot of chemistry involved there to learn the weights of the paints, the weight of the water, what you put in water, and every paint is different depending on the pigment. So there's a lot to learn for sure. It's like I'm going to school every day. So the other one that I like, it's also very fluid, and this is my first piece that I've made, is the resin art. So my first piece I made like maybe 3 days ago, I think. So now it's fully cured and dried. So I'm gonna just put it closer a little bit. So this is my first attempt ever, and this is what I've done with it. I don't know if you can see, there's white color, there's some gold, and there is some pink as well. I think this is quite neat. I wanted something really pale. I wanted something very gentle. I'm not in love exactly with a pattern, but it was my first time. Once you try to work with resin, you only have 30 minutes and it's done. So first time I was like panicking there. What am I doing? So for this one here, I use, it's called Kama Pigments. Actually, there's a blue one here as well. So Kama Pigments, I buy them online from Quebec. I believe they're located in Montreal somewhere. And I really like the company, so I think I'm gonna keep buying them. I know some people use mica pigments as well, but this is good for me. So this piece has some white inside. And then I use Pebeo because I love Pebeo. I like the fantasy moon that I used for this art piece I just showed you, and I have have as well the antique pink from Pebeo as well. So the only thing is that the pink on this art piece and the gold are not too drastically different colors in, so you can see the difference, and that was intentional. I just thought the pink will show a little bit more. So it's very gentle. I still like it, but it's my first piece, so. And artists, we're most of the time always hard on ourselves. What's good, what's not, who likes it, who doesn't. I made so many things before that like some people are like, wow, this is great. And I'm like, how did I put these colors together? But we all have different tastes. Definitely we have different tastes, and the journey of the art is also to expand the perceptions and to let yourself create something that you never thought you will ever do. So for resin, I buy art resin. I did some research and this one was the best for me. I think because it's clear and it doesn't smell. So there's a resin part and there's the hardening part. So you need those two bottles. I buy them on Amazon. Actually, all my materials for the first resin piece here are gonna be on my website. So the link is below in the description. So one thing about resin, if you would like to do it as a hobby, it is expensive. So my goal is that eventually all my art will have to be sold. It's no matter where and what I need to do for that. I will definitely do some promotional stuff and some advertisement, but it has to go because I want to keep creating new stuff, but it's very costly if you use resin. Like these two bottles here, I think together they are 1 liter 89 per bottle, so together it's about 375, I think, liters. And I think it cost me $156. What else is missing? Well, I guess the wood panels. I do prime them before with a certain color. So this is my piece. I'm glad to share it with you. I took photos of it. I took a video of it, which is at the end. I took the whole process in a video as well. So you can follow. It's about four or five minutes, I think, after I stop talking here. So you can look through the process and the final piece. I'm really happy what I created so far for my first attempt. I'm looking forward to do more of these and explore different patterns. I know there's different ways of doing patterns on this. So this is really cool. It gets me excited. One thing that really, really, really drives me to do fluid art is just the fact that you don't have 100% control what you're doing. We live a life where pretty much everything we want to control. And I feel like there's no moments where you really go deep and let go of what's outside of you. So this kind of art puts me in a situation where I can relax, trust the process, and also let go of control as well. And because most of the time you can create a certain pattern, but then the chemistry of everything just creates other things that you would have never thought. I don't want to make this video too long, but in every video you learn something about me. I don't want to post only about art as well. I might actually have other ideas here. So maybe it's gonna be like a little vlog, whatever I find interesting I would like to share with you. So I'll keep doing this, and so you'll get to know me a little bit more. But for now, this is it. And thank you very much for watching.